Governor Brewer, in justifying the state's immigration law, has repeatedly said that the federal government is not doing its job. Do you see this legislation in part as an answer to that criticism? And I'm also wondering if you can talk about what conversations, we know she met with the president earlier this year, that you have had with her, your successor.
Well, I'll take it in two ways. One is, I think her factual premise was just wrong. The facts are the facts, and the facts are that there are you know, more Border Patrol agents at that border than ever before. There's more infrastructure at the border than ever before. There's more technology at the border than ever before. There's more air cover at the border than ever before. And the results are the results. The results are that illegal crossings are way down, and seizures of drugs and guns and cash are way up. And so I think that the factual premise that she posited, which is that somehow the federal government had ignored Arizona, was just inaccurate and unfairly so. And we will continue to augment the resources that we have been putting into Arizona, particularly the east side of the state, which is known as the Tucson sector. You know, when I was the U.S. attorney, I supervised the prosecution of at least 6,000 immigration felonies. This is an area I know quite well. And I will tell you, there has never been a greater federal presence at this border. So the factual premise for the bill was wrong. Now, I did meet with Governor Brewer in Boston during the NGA, and we just discussed all the things that we were doing at the Arizona border. It was very, very professional and cordial conversation.
Yes, ma'am.
Madam Secretary. The Republicans along the way have said that you have to secure the border first. You yourself have listed a number of steps that the administration has taken during the past 18 months. My question to you is, first of all, how will the administration respond? Because there are already Republicans saying that this is an important first step, but more has to be done. The question is, when will the border be secure? Who will certify that the border is secure if that is what is needed to get comprehensive immigration reform? How do you respond to that?
Well, I think this is more than a first step. I mean, I go back to March of 2009 when we began moving assets and resources down into the southwest border. So I disagree with that characteristic. Secondly, as I've said before, this is a great bill for us. This is a great bill. It adds 1,000 Border Patrol agents. It adds ICE agents. It adds air cover. It adds other technology. It helps us make sure we have the most up-to-date communications technology at the border, which is really important because some areas are you can't cover with a cell phone because there aren't any cell towers down there. So you really need the communications capacity. You know, that part is there, and what I would simply say is sometimes I hear securing the border and the goalpost just keeps moving. Well, we've done this. Well, you need to do this. And I say, look, we will continue to do everything we need to do to have a safe and secure southwest border. We will continue to do everything we need to do. We work with counties along that border. We now have the secure community system, as I said before, in every one of the 25 counties along the border. We will continue to make sure that our efforts are informed by good intelligence and analysis, so we're not just throwing money at the border. That should not be used anymore to preclude discussions about immigration reform. As I've said many times, these should not be sequential. They should go together.
Yes, ma'am.
Got two questions, Madam Secretary. One of them, ICE has said that they can only get to 400,000 deportations a year because they just don't have the more resources. I wonder if this bill would provide some more resources to get some more deportations. And the second one is, some activists have said that by passing this bill alone, the most radical had hijacked the debate on comprehension immigration reform, and I would like to hear your reaction on that.
Well, I think it is likely that we will see more deportations, particularly in the priority categories I have set forth. Can I give you a number just yet? No. It would be premature to do so. But obviously, our goal is to make the best, most efficient use of the money that we receive from the Congress and focus it on where we think the best efforts ought to be, and that is making sure we are removing from our country criminal aliens, felony fugitives, gang members who are also in our country illegally, particularly once they've served their sentences. For those who say suggest that somehow this bill is radical, what did you say? What was the phrase you used?
The debate that by passing this bill alone, the radicals have hijacked the debate basically and moving to more law enforcement type.
No, I think that's just wrong. I think this bill is a bill that the president asked for. He asked for it because we know that we can make good use of these monies for permanent and consistent across the border security, and that's what we want to have. But that in no way should be read to suggest, imply, or in any way back off from the fact that we also need immigration reform.
Yes, ma'am.
Madam Secretary, Senator McCain and Kyle said yesterday that key elements of border security are still missing. For example, implementation of Operation Streamline in the Tucson sector and more border patrol agents, among other things. So I was wondering, do you agree with this statement? Do you agree that these kind of measures are still needed in the border?
Well, again, Operation Streamline has proven effective in some places where it is used. We use it in some places. It's very expensive, and there are other methods that we use that have proven equally effective. And so, as you're trying to make the best use of taxpayer dollars and make sure that they're targeted where they can do the best, and Streamline is one way. Repatriation into the interior of Mexico is another way that has proven very effective. And so we need a lot of different kinds of tools in our toolbox. And I think it is a mistake to focus on any single one and say, well, if you don't have that tool, you don't have an effective system. We have a good toolbox. We have a good system. And now with these monies, again, passed with the support of Senator McCain and Kyle, we can do even more.
We'll take one more from them.
Just a follow-up, a quick follow-up. Madam Secretary, you said that leadership is needed from the Republicans and Democrats in Congress in order to have comprehensive immigration reform. But in Congress, they said that leadership in the White House is needed in order to have comprehensive immigration reform.
Only Congress can pass a bill. The president can advocate. He can get them to the table, as he has in the Roosevelt Room upstairs. He can implore. He can provide ideas. He can agree to a framework, as he already has. He can give a major address that spells out what's needed in a bill. But only Congress can pass a bill.
Take one more in the very back.
The businesses from India and U.S. have said that the portion of the bill which raises the fee on H-1 and L-1 visa is discriminatory, and this would undermine the growing economic relationship between India and U.S. What's your comment on that?
I don't think it will. I think the United States and India have a robust and vital relationship, and nothing in this bill should interfere with that.
Just a follow-up about the WTO scenario where the U.S. can be taken to the WTO rules are being violated with this bill.
That I can't comment to. That has not been raised to me at all.
Thank you, Madam Secretary.
All right. Thank you.